Recording. Okay. I hope last session you enjoyed some of the end game concepts and what are the possibilities in end game that we saw, right? Importance of end game, because something seemingly obviously like material advantage, etc., doesn't exactly work as it is. You need to know the techniques and you need to have the perfect knowledge. So we saw about fortresses when even a material advantage was not helping, or we saw Zug Zwang when the same almost equal position was either going for a win for white or win for black, depending on very small changes and who is to move, etc., right? And then we also saw the sacrifice that is required sometimes to actually win. So we will continue, I think, our this one, and I'm going to be starting with so there is a concept called as opposition in end games, and which you need to understand, and I will explain it by this. Okay, so we will take a very simple, that's the beauty of end games. You can start with extremely simple positions and still understand a lot of what you call nuances, lot of intricacies, lot of things that are there. So that is like really wonderful in end game. So we are going to take this first position, okay, and see what is the no problem. That is fine. But even when you are logged in, you can actually, without having to exit, you can just rename yourself. That option is there. But even if you don't know, that's fine. It's okay. No problem. Okay. Fine. So what is the thing is, okay, so we are just going to see how the two kings, nothing else. So it will look like it is a drawn position, which is, it is indeed a drawn position. But what I'm saying is there are some concepts to learn even in a, just when the kings are on the board. Okay. So I'm going to put this position on the board, almost this position. Okay. And I will ask you, one of you, to play from the white side. I will play from the back side. See, white is, king is on say g3, okay, or whatever it is, f3, okay, and then let me go to the position. Yeah, this is the, okay, so this is the position. Black king not here but here, okay, that's fine, and it is white to move, okay, so done. Okay, so let us see this. Okay, so you're as white, you are going to start the playing, and your aim is, see, king is on g3, don't allow the black king to come on let us say f3 and e3 and d3, any of these three squares you need to defend, or let us just take f3 and e3. Okay, you should not allow black king to come to f3 and e3. That is your objective. Okay, so I will just go by thing some let us say Ahan. Okay, I'm going to ask Ahan. I'm going to unmute him, and Ahan, you are going to play white, I'm going to play black. Okay, please unmute yourself. Hey, hi. Okay, Amodini joining. Amodini and Lakshmi.
I can't see the screen.
Hey, hi Amodini, Lakshmi.
Sir, I can't see the screen.
You can't see the screen. Have I not shared the screen? Let me just check it. Why is that? Can everyone else? Oh, security may. I have not allowed renaming. Huh? Rename themselves. Okay. Now I have allowed. Let me see if. Why is, you are not able to see the screen? Have I not shared the screen?
It's just a black screen. I can see you, but I can't see the screen. It's totally black screen.
Is that for everyone? Okay, others can see it. There must be some. You can still can't see it, Ahan?
No, sir. It's not visible.
There must be some problem. But because everybody else can see it. So, okay. So, fine. I mean, you just try checking something. Meanwhile, I'll go to Sai Abhinav. Yeah. Sai Abhinav, you are playing white. You heard the thing. You are supposed to defend, not allow the black king to come to f3 or e3 squares. Okay. If I come there, I am going to unmute you. Sorry. Where is Sai Abhinav? Sai Pranav, sir. Sai Abhinav was there just now. Okay, Abhinav. Okay, all right. Just 1 second. This keeps. Abhinav, yeah, Abhinav, you can hear me, right? You and me will talk. Okay. So you can play for white. Okay, start playing for white. I will start playing.
What is the goal again?
Sorry?
What is the goal? Like, what
goal is not allow black king to come to e3 or f3.
You're
on g3. Yeah.
Do I play?
Yeah, white to play. You just tell me your move and I will make it.
f4.
No, f4. King to f4, you mean. Okay.
Yeah.
King to d5. Okay.
King to e3.
King to e3. Okay. King to e5. Okay.
King f3.
King f3. Okay. King d4.
King e2.
King e2. Okay, king e4.
King f2.
King f2. All right. King d3.
King f3.
King f3. Okay. King d2.
King f2.
King f2. Okay. Finally, now you have got the thing. I have come almost, I'm touching the square, right? The e3 or the f3 square, but I'm not able to come now further. I'm not able to come in because you are creating a blockade. And can you see when the kings are in this position, there is a blockade, right?
Yes.
The other side cannot come nearer or whatever it is. So when the kings are facing each other from one square, right, that is called as a opposition. Okay, so now whoever has to move cannot make progress. So if black is to move, black is like against a wall, it will have to move sideways somewhere, right? So he will have to lose the opposition. That is called as losing the opposition. Whoever can maintain it is called as having the opposition. Okay, but good, I think you played well. Finally, though my king came very close, after that it was not able to make a progress. Okay, so this is the right thing, but you need to get this absolutely right. Okay, so that is why what I have suggested is some exercises for you to keep practicing this. Okay, just practice it with two kings alone. Maybe have someone of your friend or whoever is there, your dad, sister, brother, or whoever, to play against you. But try to do this thing right. So I have given exactly the positions you can try out. So so you can some variants of it I have given. But please try this out so that you get to know exactly what is that opposition and how to not allow a king. Okay, not allow a king to come to any particular square, but not, I mean, as long as it is near your king, you can easily defend it. If I tell, okay, now let us try one more game. Sai Abhinav, since you have got this, or maybe somebody else, I'll give it. Okay, so this one I'm going to close it. Save, no. So back to here, I'm going to set up a new position. Not this, slightly farther away, okay? I'm going to be black and you are going to be white. So what you need to prevent is now D3, E3 and F3. Okay, these three squares you need to prevent. White should try to prevent F3, E3 and D3 by being occupied by the black king. Three squares. Okay. So who is going to be my playing partner? Let me see. Ahan, I don't know whether you still can't see your screen, but okay, let me go to Akshay. Akshay, I'm going to unmute you. You can unmute yourself. You are going to be playing white in this position. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So play your move. Your objective is not allow black king to come to f3, e3 or d3. These three squares.
Okay, sir.
So play. Tell me your move first. You are playing.
Sir, g2.
King to g2. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I am coming king to g7.
Sir, f2.
King to f2. King to f6.
Sir, e2.
King to e2. Okay. King to e5.
Sir, then... Sir, king to e3.
King to e3. Okay. You have very smartly grabbed the opposition. But let me see what is possible here. King to d5.
Sir, king to d3.
King to d3. Okay, very smart. Now, let me play king to d6.
Sir, king to d4.
Ah, good. Okay. King to e6.
Sir, e4.
Wow, good. So it looks like you have already know this thing very well. So you are playing very well. I mean, so this is the way to play. See, you are trying to block me now. Forget about f3, e3 and d3. Now my king will not be, in fact, in this position now, he will not be able to come to f4, e4 and d4 also, because your king, you have come forward and blocked me. Right? But yes, yeah, sir. This is exactly the technique. So I hope everyone who has seen this understands this, how he has played, right? I just want to go one move back, a few moves back. Okay, now here you played, at this point you played king to e2, right?
Yes, so sir.
I play king to e6 here. Now let us see, what is the...
Sir, e3.
King to e3. Okay, now I come to e5.
So king to sir f3.
King to f3. King to d4.
Sir, king to e2.
King to e2. King to e4.
Sir, d2.
King to d2. I have won. King to f3.
Oh,
okay.
Yes, sir.
Good, but I mean, you are doing good, but you have to understand, that's what I think. So I will just go back and see where the error was made. Okay. There was still some time to recover, but fundamental error was made in this position. See, when the opposition is there, when kings are separated by one square facing each other, or three squares or five squares. Okay. All the three are is called as opposition. Now, whoever breaks this opposition is at a disadvantage. So I didn't come to E5, because then I would have lost the opposition, because I have only two squares between my king and your king, right? That is not the opposition. Then you will play to king to E3 and you will get the opposition. So here I maintained the opposition by playing king to E6. Now, at this point of time, if you play, if you want to, either you could have played f3, that would have been okay.
Yes, sir.
Or d3 would have been okay, but not e3. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Because you saw what happens. If you play king e3, then I play king e5, and now I have got the opposition. Because yes, I am coming in with one square in between. Now you have to move sideways and then I get entry point somewhere. Either whichever way, if you go to left side, then I'll come to the right. If you go to right side, then I'll come to the left. Right?
Yes, sir.
Right? Instead, if you had played here king to f3, then what black would have done? If black had gone here, then you would have played here, still got under control. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And even if he plays here, oh, there is still a problem. So that, yeah, actually, so if king f3, then black, yeah, black will try to play this. But what should you play? In fact, you are right. Actually, the moment you move like this, I have, see, you see the problem of the opposition now. Anyway.
Yes, sir.
See, now black is actually making headway, no matter what white plays. Black is going to encroach.
Yes, sir.
Because even crosswise, right, this is still a opposition. Black still has got opposition, because even diagonally, if there is one square in between, it is still a strong position for whoever comes in with that. So whatever white plays, let us say white plays at this point of time. I don't know. I mean, whatever move I'm thinking, it is like black is making entry. If he goes here, then black comes here.
Yes, sir.
Right? If he goes here, then also black comes to e4 and then he has made entry. Let me see who is playing some on the chat. Right? No, it is. I mean, yeah, okay. The result, see, we are not discussing here about because anyway, kings are there, two kings are there, so it is not going to be a thing. But what we are saying is how to prevent them from entering. It is like protecting your land. Okay, that is also some. I mean, why I'm saying is that why we are showing it with just the kings is that it is very simple to understand when there is no disturbance with pawns and anything. Okay. That's why first you just understand it with just the kings. Then you will be able to apply it in other positions where there are pawns, knight, bishop, etc. Okay. But it is very important to understand this opposition concept just when the two kings are there. So that is the reason why I have given you this homework assignments to be done with these things. You please go through it and do it. But you saw how interesting it becomes. Even slight variations, right? It is, we are not able to think. So because the black has now got the opposition. The moment black gets the opposition, it is at a disadvantage. Can you think of any way that now at this position, now after king e4, black is winning. Because no matter what white does, he will get to entry to one of the three squares. F3, e3 or d3. It cannot prevent all three. All three of them, it can only protect it by king already being on e2 and not having to make a move. The moment white king has to make a move, it is like Zugzwang, right? What we learned last session. So, anybody has any? So no problem. Anybody has any doubt on this one? You want to see some more variations or something? Right, but getting that thing is very, very important. Okay, getting the opposition. Okay, there are some more things. So this was a nice thing. So maybe I will just switch to. Okay, now we will switch to one more position here. Now this is like exactly balanced position, right? Two black pawns, two white pawns facing each other on the same files. Two kings facing each other at extreme away. Now let us try to see how to move this. Okay, so I'm going to be having somebody else now who is going to be my partner. I'm just going alphabetically. So Abhinav is done, Akshay is done. Okay, Alfia, you are going to be next. So you are going to be playing from white side. I'm going to be playing from black side. So unmute yourself. Okay, and you tell me your moves.
And so am I supposed to protect any square?
Yeah, you just tell me what move you will make, either a pawn or king or whatever, and I will make it, and then I will make my move. Okay.
King to g2.
King to g2 you want to make. Okay, king to g2. So what I want to do is, let me see. But okay, I will give you one, this one actually. Only the kings, ignore the kings, okay, for the part. Only try to play with the pawns, because that's what I'm trying to teach here. Just the pawn play. Don't play with the kings. We'll keep the kings aside. I will also not move my king. You also don't move. Try to just move the pawns.
Okay, then A3.
A3, okay. A3. A3 is the, in fact, I will promote this promote variation. Okay, A3. If you are playing A3, then okay, I am playing B5. Now you play
B3 or
B4? B3? B3, yeah? B3 or B4? Okay.
B3.
No, B3 or B4?
B3.
B3, okay. B3 you play. Fine. So, now... A5, I play A5.
We can't move the kings.
No, you can't move the king. You are only supposed to move the pawns.
A4.
Okay. Fine. I think we are going to draw the game because I'm going to play B4, and this is a draw. Okay. So good. So I think you played well. I think what is to be appreciated is that you didn't play your pawns to two squares just like that. So in fact, I played it, but I thought about it and then I played it because there are some dangers that happen if you simply play in the end game, if you play pawns too much fast, right? Actually, you need to have some moves in your reserve. So I think you played really well. So let us see. Good. I think this is with perfect play. It is draw between white and black. If somebody makes mistakes, then one of the pawns will go through. So let me go to. I will set up one more position.
The technique is my first and
okay. So, but well played. So now I will get someone, another person. So clear board and okay, white king here. Similar thing, but slightly different now. So now white has got pawns on A2 and B2, and black has got on B7 and C7. It is again white to move. Okay, so this is the position. And who is going to be playing with me? It is going to be Ansh. Ansh, you are going to play. You can unmute yourself. Okay, and don't move the king. Kings are not allowed to move here, just because I was just want to teach, right? That's why. I mean, there is nothing else, but we will not play our kings. We'll play only with the pawns. You play from the white side, I play from the black side. So tell me your move.
Pawn to A3.
Pawn to A3. Okay, let me think. Okay, I play C5.
Pawn to A4.
Pawn to A4. Excellent. I play A3.
Pawn to B3.
Very good. Very good. Very smart. So now you know. Now it is black has lost it. Because just assume kings are not going to play. Black, whichever way, whichever pawn now black moves, black is going to lose that pawn.
Right?
And it's essentially white is winning. So you saw, who is the unknown user? I don't know. Who is the unknown user? Let me see, because we have to be careful. Is there anybody unknown user? Oh, there is no unknown user. Okay, it is okay. We are safe. There was only some George guy trying to enter, which I didn't allow. That may have... Okay, I don't know. Maybe that person has left and rejoined. That's the thing. Okay. That's fine. All right. So, but you saw why what is the mistake that happened? Because I played the pawn two squares, right? And white could take advantage of this thing, right? So that is why I just wanted to illustrate that. Be very careful in pawn endgames before making your, moves or making advancing your pawn too fast. Okay. So we'll see what if black had also played very reservedly, right? Black had also played c6 instead of c5. Okay, Ansh, play your move now.
Pawn to a4.
All right. Pawn to a4. Okay. So. So I play now c5.
Pawn to a5.
Okay, excellent. I play c4. Now it is looks like white is losing, right?
Yeah.
Right? Very interesting, right? But just a small move here and there makes a lot of difference, right? It is white because if he plays a6, black will capture on a6. If he plays b3, black will capture on b3. If he plays b4, then also en passant is there and black will capture it. So black will capture white's pawn, right? And so black is winning, right? So very interesting. You saw how a small move difference and the right way of restraint actually. Here it was not attack that has proved useful, but defense is what has proved useful. And so I think what you should do is after c6, I think you should play Ansh, you should play b3. Okay. That may be giving you better chances. So after b3, then what I will also do is, what I will do? I will also play b6, not b5. But you saw what happens if I play b5. If I play b5, then white wins by playing b4. Now, whatever black does, black has only one move, and that is going to lose the pawn. Right? So, again, you saw that making up advance of too fast actually loses. So instead, black plays b6. I hope everyone got it, right? If black plays b5, white has simply plays b4. Now forcing black to move, zugzwang, and after that capturing the pawn. So instead of that, I play b6. Now you play
pawn to a.
Pawn to a4. Okay. Now I play c5. Yeah, it has become losing position for white. Correct. It has become now. Because now whatever white plays now is going to lose it. But anyway, so that's fine. I mean, it is. So I hope all of you understood the intricacies around these end games. And now the best way to actually learn this, whatever now white moves after this will be losing. Okay. Yeah, Rishita, you have raised a hand. Please go ahead. Tell your question. Ask your question. Oh, Sadma is also saying, who is there? I'm not able to see unknown user. For some reason, you are saying that.
I can see unknown user. It has no name.
And I'm not able to see any such. How many users, participants do you see? 15 or 16?
15.
Yeah, 15. I also see 15. But maybe I'm not seeing.
But something. I see.
Okay, fine. I think we'll figure that out. It is Aha, no? Okay, I don't know.
There is an unknown user.
I don't know. Okay, that's fine, I think. Anyway, we are ending our session. Okay, now I'm about to end it. But I hope everyone got a sense of these things. And now what is important is you try out. I have given you almost 13, 14 variants of positions to try out. Okay. So I starting with a key position and then some variations. Additional practice diagram. Okay, this is diagram one. Then this is diagram two. But you can make variations within that. Okay. And then like this variation, etc. And then similarly, you play it out. Then I played out this diagram three. I played out. There are variations of that I played out. But this is only with two pawns on board. But then I also have given you practice for playing three pawns on board, either straight in front of each other or one offset of one. Okay. But it is very, very important that you try all of this. Yeah, I also don't know. I think I will figure that out, who is the unknown or whatever. So I think fine. We are going to end now. Okay. And we are going to jump back into our practice games. Okay. I'm going to send a handout now. All right. So.